In December of 1941, Japanese troops attacked Hong Kong and quickly overwhelmed the British colony's defenders. Later that month, an ad in major newspapers called on writers and intellectuals to register with the occupation authorities. If they complied, many would be targets of the Japanese military police for their anti-Japanese writings. There was no way to escape from occupied Hong Kong, yet those targeted by the ad seemed to vanish overnight. The Japanese bombed the U.S. naval base at Pearl Harbor on December 7, 1941. In Hong Kong, it was early in the morning of December 8th. Residents were jolted awake at a scream of Japanese planes dive bombing the city.
We saw Japanese planes bombing the city. 当时大家都比较惊慌，轰炸完以后，防空警报一响起来，轮渡轮就要停下来，不能动的，汽车都不能动的，我们哪一个动了就是一定会成为被袭击的目标。On
December 25th, the Battle of Hong Kong ended. Governor Mark Atchison Young was captured. The Japanese would occupy Hong Kong for 3 years and 8 months.
印象最深刻的是这样，母亲马上下命令，到后街的米店买一包蓝线包大米。这蓝线包大米就是一大包的180司马斤。这日本攻打香港，我们全家就靠了180斤米了。The
Japanese army took control. The streets were sealed off, and a curfew was announced. Members of the government and military were rounded up. The intellectuals who had criticized Japan would be hunted down. The Japanese army conducted house-to-house searches at night. Kosuka Wakata, a Japanese culture spy, asked Mei Lan Fang, Sai Chu Shung, and C2 Wei Min to meet with the Japanese command. He also published a notice asking Mao Dun and Zhou Taofun to come out of hiding so they could establish the Great East Asia Co-Prosperity Sphere together. To avoid detection, Zhou Taofun moved 6 times and eventually found sanctuary in a slum. Liu Yaze, a senior member of the Kuomintang, took shelter in a refugee camp. He Xiongning and her family moved to the office of the China Defense League. During the Battle of Hong Kong, Mao Dun and his wife had almost lost their lives.
打仗期间，英国跟日本人开战期间四五天，几乎是据说啊，每天下午。 都有三发炮弹，三发炮弹落在这个舞蹈学校附近。那么在最后一天，他们快要离开这个舞蹈学校的时候，日本人放了2颗炮弹，一颗炮弹呢，这个正好落到这个他们学校附近的一个商行，商行就烧起来了；还有一颗炮弹正好落在他们这个他们住的那个舞蹈学校的屋顶。 幸亏他们是在三楼，因为屋顶还有几层呢，大概这个5层4层。那么矛盾他们的8个人就住在这个3层，非常危险，就正好他们屋顶上。那一天就是24号，那一天炸了以后，他们连夜就赶快去走。As
they took refuge in one hiding place to another, it was difficult for the more than 1,000 people on the blacklist to avoid detection. It seemed the only option was to await their fate. When the Battle of Hong Kong began, Liao Chengzhe of the 8th Route Army's Bureau got several urgent telegrams from the Party Central Committee. He was urged to get his staff and party supporters to Southeast Asia or the guerrilla zone by any means possible. Liao immediately made contact with Yin Linping, commissar of a guerrilla unit in Guangdong.
当时接到中央的指示之后呢，廖承志呢就对林平说，这一次呢可由你来扛大旗了，你们的部队要做好抢救的准备。
抗日游击队当时呢是两个大队，林平是这两个大队的这个政委，曾生是这个是司令的副司令，王兆饶，这三个人经过研究以后呢，分工啊，尹林平干什么？啊，司令指的曾生干什么？副司令王兆饶干什么？
A large-scale rescue began. On the afternoon of December 18th, in the Gloucester Hotel dining hall and cafe, Liao had a meeting with intellectuals and party supporters. He explained he would help escort them to Kowloon and then to inland China.The Japanese Army's blockade between Hong Kong and Kowloon was the first barrier. Liao An Shiung was an inventory keeper in Hong Kong. He had often helped the Hong Kong Bureau relay information. He passed along the news that Hong Kong lacked food and the Japanese wanted to drive people out of the colony.
因为他要吃要住要什么的嘛，所以他不想负担那么多人，所以呢，他是给那些就中国人呢，可以自由撤离香港的，他给他们走的。
Castle Peak Road was crowded with refugees, young and old. They all carried luggage. Each day, over 100,000 people rushed to get away. This provided a channel for the evacuation.Liao put the rescue plan into motion, but found he had difficulty leaving Hong Kong. Liao, Lian Guan, and Chao Guan Hua were in a perilous position. Many people knew they worked for the 8th Route Army. They would be prime suspects of the Japanese manhunt.On the second day of January in 1942, Liao, Lian, and Chao dressed as merchants in order to slip through the Japanese blockade line. A guerrilla named Li Jian Xing guided them to Kowloon by boat. They met up with Yin Lin Ping, and the four pretended to be playing Mahjong.In this way, they discussed the plan to escort dozens of people out of Hong Kong by land and sea.
廖公见了我就第一句就问他：“你带部队下来没有？”我们父亲就说：“带了，啊，带了部队下来。”他说：“当时呢，已经成立了两支那个，就是两支手枪队，啊，一支在开辟了西线，啊，一支开辟了东线，而且呢，还准备呢，就是搞一支护航大队。”啊，后来廖公听了就很高兴，他说：“哦，那这样的话呢，那个从九龙撤到那个游击区这一段的工作就交给你了。”
The Western route went overland. It started at Castle Peak Road and eventually led to the guerrilla zone. The Eastern route was over water.It started in Kowloon and eventually reached the guerrilla zone. The guerrillas set up secret communication points along these two routes and made emergency plans. They anxiously awaited the refugees.Du Jin An worked at the headquarters of the East River Column. He still has a note left by Mao Dun. It gives details of how they walked dozens of miles and eventually crossed the blockade line.
我们送给他，就在后面写着他不喜欢，
不喜欢，
他叫我们换一个，调换，我们给他写他换一个，换一个脚长的。他个老婆，他老婆好胖的，他两夫妇都跑出来，都跑到我那去了，他当时他要换一个鞋子，所以我就马上去找衣服送给他，鞋子送给他，是这样子。
On January 9th, 1942, a group of refugees with luggage on their backs moved from Lockhart Road to Sugar Street in Causeway Bay. They were under the protection of the liaison man of the 8th Route Army's Hong Kong office.This was the first group that would be evacuated. Mao Dun, his wife, Ye Yi Chun, and Ge Bao Chuan were among them. Under the cover of darkness, they got through an opening that had been cut in the wire fence. They boarded a small boat that carried them to a larger vessel in the typhoon shelter. When Mao Dun met Zhou Tao Fun, Hu Sheng, Liao Moshe, and Yu Ling,They were all excited and asked one another about their experiences after the outbreak of fighting. At 3 o'clock the next morning, the sea was covered with a thick fog. They took advantage of the time when the Japanese army changed the guards and the coastal defenses were slack.They quickly made their way to Kowloon on three boats. The following morning, Zhou Tao Fun, Mao Dun, and others mingled with the refugees who had been forced out of Hong Kong by the Japanese army. Guided by a liaison man, they walked for dozens of miles, past Japanese soldiers and along a path over Big Hat Mountain, a place riddled with bandits.
天晚上正在走的时候，他们经过一个桥，毛泽东的夫人孔德子啊，一个不小心从桥上掉下去了。这个桥离水面呢有大概5-6米高，毛泽东就叫了，说不好了不好了，我的孔德子，我的夫人掉下去了，大家赶快救啊。那么大家就有人就用手电筒照，往下面照，一照呢照了深不见底，也看不到下面究竟怎么回事了。幸亏这个时候是正好是枯水期，掉在岸边的水草跟泥浆的地方，所以也没受伤。
On January 12th, the fourth day after fleeing Hong Kong, they finally began the last leg of their journey to the guerrilla zone.Mei Lin Ao Mountain was a natural barrier to the south. When they reached the mountaintop, the guerrilla fighters met them at a prearranged spot.
Because Hong Kong and Shenzhen are very close, our refugee group sent a large group to there to meet these refugee group, to meet these Chinese people. At the time, from Hong Kong, there were two routes to bring them.一条是走海边的水路，一条是走这个内地的一个是陆路，两条路汇合以后就在宝安的白石龙，在那个地方汇合。那个白石龙当时是东江游击队一个大队的驻地。
The headquarters of the anti-Japanese guerrilla force was in Bai Shalong village at the foot of Mei Lin Ao Mountain. A Catholic church was the best building in the village. Zheng Shung and Wang Zor Rao allowed the refugees to use it while they themselves lived in a makeshift cottage. Several days later, dramatist Fung Zhe led 40 members of a performance troupe to the same place.Later, more people started to arrive. By the end of January, over 300 had arrived in the guerrilla zone. Following them were over 1,000 more. They were all very excited at having escaped occupied Hong Kong. They called themselves culture guerrillas. The quiet valley started to bustle with activity. They expressed their happiness through singing. When the evacuation plan was created, it was decided the refugees leaving Hong Kong via water would do so because they had been there for a long time. Their identity might be disclosed on the land route. A cafe in Sai Kung was an important communication point on the water route. Waitress Jiang Wan Hua was an intelligence agent of the East River Column.
开那个原乡食堂，那个电话来的本来日本鬼子来了，他就转移到西宫里面，就开这个博亚天。那么后来部队呢，就叫我在那里做服务员，啊，另外负责的交通情报，那些文化人士也不知道讲不知道他的什么名了，啊，就这样的一批一批。
As more refugees escaped along this route, the coastal area became a place where Japanese intelligence and guerrillas wrestled for control. The Kuomintang and the Communist Party began a short period of cooperation to ensure a particular woman got away safely. Under the protection of Dai Li, a movie star named Hu Da came to the East River Column's communication point in Sai Kung.
他们就在那谈好了，在不夜天里面谈了，谈那些怎么样救蝴蝶。我们呢，就是人家呢，把他的行李啊，从九龙挑到西贡来。It
took a week for the guerrillas to transfer Hu's luggage. Unfortunately, she didn't show up at the appointed time. Early the next morning, the Japanese army encircled Sai Kung and carried out a search. Hu Da finally arrived at noon. She was distressed to learn that her luggage had been taken away by the Japanese.
Hu Da 当场就哭起来了，他说我做那个电影明星啊。 全副的新家都在那里，什么军人珠宝啊，都在那个船上里面了。哇，现在没有了。然后王刚华就暗叫他哈、啊，明星，楼的青山在，不怕没条下哦，啊，以后可以站回来的。The
evacuation along the western route went smoothly, but there was a problem on the eastern route. He Xiong Ning and Liu Yaze got lost. He Xiong Ning and Liu Yaze were senior members of the Kuomintang. The 8th Route Army's office arranged for them to take a boat to Macau. Their advanced age meant the land route was not a good choice for them. Taking a boat was more realistic. Changzhou Island, southwest of Hong Kong, was part of their escape route. The Communist Party had been active there for a long time. After the Japanese seized Hong Kong, the island wasn't closely guarded. It remained under the control of the Communists. The island was a reliable transfer station where those rescued from Hong Kong could be transferred to Macau. Traveling by motorboat, Ha and Liu should not have needed long to reach the island. Several days passed, but they still didn't show up.
我父亲在当地的，当时是比较有威信，他就组织了那个很多的渔民，称把这开上船到海里去找，不知道他们去哪里了，都在海上找了一个礼拜也没找到。
They had been delayed because the Japanese army had forced all ships leaving Hong Kong to remove their engines. Without a motor, the boat had only a small sail for propulsion, and the journey took 7 days. They arrived at Haiphong with the help of the East River Column's patrol ship. During the rescue, the Hong Kong Bureau and the guerrilla force opened another two routes. One took the refugees to a point where they had to go ashore and walk to the guerrilla zone. The other route was via Macau. Chow Shi Ung Ling took this route when she escorted Sai Chu Shun. The last evacuee to leave Hong Kong was Gao Shaqi. He was ill and unable to move by himself. Protected by Huang Chu Yun, he left Hong Kong in April and went to Guilin via Guangzhou. The Japanese attempt to round up writers and intellectuals had failed. They had escaped occupied Hong Kong and reached safe areas where they could continue their work. The exploits of the 8th Route Army's Hong Kong office and the guerrilla force became widely known. In February of 1942, the East River Guerrilla Force was reorganized into the East River People's Anti-Japanese Guerrilla Column. Its Hong Kong Kowloon Brigade then became active in southern China. Many military operations awaited them. Join us for part 5, Intelligence Station.